Welcome to another edition of Credit Matters TV. I'm Richard Courtwright, a managing director in the Corporate Ratings Group. El Paso Corporation is one of the country's largest natural gas pipeline operators, as well as a significant domestic natural gas producer. The company has just announced that it intends to separate these businesses into two independent publicly traded companies by the end of this year. The separation will be effected by means of a tax-free spin-off of the exploration and production company. With me in the studio to discuss the various credit implications of this transaction is Mike Grande, a director in the Utilities and Infrastructure Practice. Mike, let me first ask you about the various rating actions that we have taken as a result of this announcement.
Sure, Richard. As a result of the announcement, we placed the ratings on El Paso Corp and its various subsidiaries on credit watch positive, which includes the exploration and production company and the domestic pipelines.
So what do you think is the potential for an uplift in the ratings, and over what time frame would this occur?
Okay. Well, pro forma for the transaction, we expect El Paso Corp is essentially going to be a pipeline company with very stable cash flows. Over 90% of the EBITDA from this company will come from fixed firm reservation charges that are independent of throughput levels, so it will be very stable. The one thing we're uncertain about is the amount of leverage that this company will have pro forma.
No announcements have been made on that.
Nothing specific. What the company did publicly state is that it won't be levered at 4x debt to EBITDA, which implies to me at least that it would be somewhat higher than that. And given the asset profile of the pro forma company, that company can take a more aggressive profile and more leverage just because of the inherent stability of the cash flows. So that's not something that's necessarily bad. We believe, based on our analysis that we're going through now, the pro forma debt to EBITDA could be anywhere from 4.5 to low 5x range, really depending on the rate of drop downs that occur between the parent and the MLP and the amount of debt reduction that provides, in addition to the amount of debt raised at E&P and the distribution that comes back to the parent, which is all still uncertain at this time. But we do believe that the pro forma company has the potential to be investment grade in the triple B category.
And we're talking here about just the pipelines company, right?
Right.
Okay, so on the E&P side, they'll have ratings as well?
Ratings as well. Currently, those ratings are double B stable. The management has announced their intention to raise $2 to $2.25 billion of debt at the E&P company. And we believe, based on that, and as the oil and gas group goes through their analysis, based on cost structure and reserves and drilling program, that company most likely will remain in the double B category.
But it too is on credit watch positive.
It too is on credit watch positive.
Okay, so we've taken a company that has a stable outlook, a single consolidated company. We're looking at two companies that are formed by separation of the different businesses, and both those companies on an individual basis are we're looking at as a credit watch positive. Kind of an unusual development, maybe?
I could see how people would think that, and I could probably provide a little bit of color on that. While the company is currently has a stable outlook, it had the potential to be building some positive credit momentum. There was a couple of things that prevented us from going on positive before, which are a little bit clearer now. One, Ruby, which is a big project that had some cost overruns and was a little bit behind schedule, is essentially complete now. It should go into service sometime in July, so there's some clarity around that. The pipelines that El Paso has went through a number of rate cases, which actually increased the amount of firm reservation charges that provided more cash flow stability. And one of their pipelines, El Paso Natural Gas, which was a little bit challenged, announced some new contracts, which firmed up some of the EBITDA there. So that's another kind of recent positive development. And also the the pace at of debt reduction and the amount of drop downs that are going to occur between the parent and the MLP, it was still somewhat uncertain, I guess, earlier in the year. There's a little bit more clarity around that, and we think that there'll be some additional debt reduction that could have provided positive momentum, absent this announcement.
Okay. Mike, thanks a lot. We'll leave it there for now.
Thanks
and thank you for tuning in.